Hi everyone, I'm Sloan from SloanBella.com and I'm back with my second video with Kate Spade. Now remember, she's been trying to pop through in between Heath Ledger and River Phoenix, which sounds really weird, but she did say I kept overthrowing her for men and she's probably right, but today she decided to step through again. I just did another video and she came through. I was literally about to walk out the door. So I'm gonna sit down and talk about what I'm feeling with her. The first time that I met her, I was actually doing laundry and there she sat on her kitchen sink. I'm not her sink, her kitchen counter. And she was like clicking her heels against the back of the cupboard, smoking a cigarette. She smokes cigarettes. I don't care what anybody says. She smokes cigarettes when she's nervous and she could see shoes coming in and she knew the person, and I'm gonna use this, she knew the person that killed her. She did not kill herself. Now, the rumors about her depression and anxiety, or the comments about her depression and anxiety, or herself expressing that she had depression and anxiety, was not quite the way that it was portrayed, because a lot of what she was feeling was being put onto her. She's kind of showing me that she was like a sponge that absorbed everything, said nothing, kept herself really quiet, and then would explode into arguments and acts of defiance. I don't know why she's saying acts of defiance. She's a grown-up and she's not in a prison camp, but that's what she's saying, acts of defiance, and she didn't quite know how to respond to things. So she's showing me all of this that's going on around her, and she's saying in this huge thing, when she first got rid of her company, when she first got into her company, this is when the anxiety started, because unbeknownst to her, she started to follow a path. And the path and the people that were put around her gave her great anxiety. She's basically showing me that she was picking up on the energy of people that were placed in her path in order to help her move forward with her job, in order to do things. So she is saying she absorbed the energy of those around her. She was never quite sure who to trust. She is showing me that in her house, and I'm gonna say this, okay? So her husband, which we know, was her husband, and she has a daughter, and there's concern over her daughter, but she feels like she's lost her daughter. Her daughter hasn't been allowed really to mention her name recently, and I'm not sure if that has something to do with the people that the daughter is around and they don't want the name mentioned because they think it's gonna be not helpful for the daughter, or if there's another reason behind it. But she's kind of upset about this, that the daughter is not allowed to talk about her the way that she wants to. I'm sure the daughter does, but not like in the way that she would like her to. The other thing that I'm seeing with her is that on a certain level, she spent the last 5 years of her life, okay, with people calling her paranoid, saying she was drinking too much, saying she had anxiety, saying she had depression, and she was like spying, like watching, like I need to watch because I don't trust them. I overhear them. They're talking. I can hear what they're saying. I really feel like her reality was splitting in different directions and she didn't know what was real and what wasn't. There was so much confusion around her and she was being mind fucked in her house, okay? So she's saying that. Those are her words, not mine, although I concur with the wording, but she was actually being mind fucked in her house by somebody in her house. There was somebody who was taking charge. You know what I'm gonna say? I'm just gonna straight out say this. There are relatives on the husband's side of the family that knowingly were used to maneuver her because she trusted them, even though they weren't technically trustworthy in reference to her. So she trusted them, so she would listen to them, but she was being maneuvered, okay? So she was being maneuvered. The last company that she opened that was another fashion company after she sold her company was not doing well. Everybody put a bunch of money and stuff into her name and it wasn't doing well and she couldn't keep up with it and she kept pointing this out and she kept saying it. She's also showing me that she's going through some paperwork of her husband's in a desk drawer, which of course there'd be a desk in the house because who doesn't have one? But she's going on the left side, she's going down, there's three drawers over here. She's digging all the way in the back and she's finding something. This paper that she's finding is like horrifying to her, okay? She has like eyes open wide and she's just like, oh, God, she turns her face. She doesn't want to deal with this. She is seeing something that's written on this paperwork or seeing something. Suddenly she gets on the computer. She's on the computer. She's researching. She's looking stuff up. She's afraid that people are watching her. She's looking around. She's like, why are these people spying on me? I can feel them spying on me. She's not sure if her house is bugged or marked. This is seriously what I'm getting. This is why she goes around the house talking to herself. Now, no one told you that, did they? She was talking to herself in her house, which made people think that she was either drunk or crazy, but she was doing that crazy like a fox so that you would think she was drunk or crazy so that you wouldn't catch her, okay? So she wanted you to think that she was crazy, drunk, whatever, so that you wouldn't question what she's doing because she's a crazy drunk person talking to herself. But she wasn't, okay? So she's playing a game. She's doing stuff. She's looking through checks. She's checking stuff out. She's concerned for her daughter. There's a school bill here. There's people connected to the school with her daughter, with the school, with these other parents, with the people, with the husband's relatives. There's people over here. There's something that's quiet over here with her family. I'm talking about Kate Spade's family, her father. This is quieted down. This is quieted down. She doesn't know which way to turn. She can't trust anybody. This is what she says. She knew that she wasn't going to live. She knew that she was going to, quote, commit suicide. She wouldn't commit suicide. I don't care what anyone says. I'm not feeling that she committed suicide. I'm not going to say she committed suicide because I don't feel that. So if you feel she did, you're entitled to your opinion and your feeling. But I'm telling you, she's amped up in me. She's like one strong woman. And she smokes the whole time she's talking to me. Maybe that was just her fantasy. You don't have to smoke on the other side, but she is smoking. It doesn't matter. She's dead. She can't really kill herself. But she's smoking on the other side. They're watching her is what she's telling me. She is being observed and it's driving her crazy. She feels like they're listening to her. So she's feeling like there's either cameras in her home. Something's bugged. Where she goes is watched. This is why she's talking to herself. Like she's like this to herself. I hear her shows. She kind of had like inside her house, there was a... She keeps going to the kitchen area. Something about the kitchen area, and maybe they can't hear her. Maybe they can't feel her. There's people in and out of the house. I feel like she had like cleaning people or helper people in the house. There's people in and out of the house, but there's a male relative on the husband's side along with the husband that know what happened to her, know that she didn't kill herself, know what went on, and are keeping their mouth shut. One of them isn't doing a good job of keeping his mouth shut, so he may have some troubles coming to him, okay, is what I'm feeling. And I don't feel it's a husband. I feel it's a husband's relative. There's a whole lot of energy going around. Oh, God, she's so tired. She's so tired, okay? She can't keep this up. This is hypervigilant. You could almost say she's paranoid. You could almost say like it's like a person who's a hypochondria and they think they've got every disease, so they have to research cancer at night. But she is looking through stuff. Checks are being sent to somebody for a reason that she doesn't like, okay? There's a connection to her daughter's school, to the parents at the school, to the social circles at the school, to the dinner parties at the school. She sits there and she's looking down the table of the last dinner party she's at, and she's realizing the web that she's in. It's a web, okay? It's a web. She's just like, it's a web. She's not happy about this. She's not happy about the last clothing company or fashion company that she opened. She didn't want to open it, but they told her to open it because there's somebody that they were trying to elicit money from by using Kate Spade's name to open this company to broke it. So if we broke it over here with Kate Spade and we pull this money in, it gives us a lot more money. This is what I'm seeing. This is what she's doing. This is the whole thing that I'm seeing. So she is on the verge of trying to figure something out. This is not a nice thing that she's trying to figure out. She's just like, this is not a nice thing. She was married to a man who was duplicitous is what she's saying. That's her word, not mine, although it's a good word. It's duplicitous. I can't stop talking. I'm like, so duh, 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 like this. Her energy is just like, oh, quickened. She's got so much to say. There's so much digging to do. She is still digging on the other side. She's talking now. She takes myself to digging. She takes myself, me, my thinking to archaeological dig, to a backhoe, to digging. She's digging up something. She's literally showing me somebody digging up something and showing me that checks are being given to the people who did the digging and whatever they found in the ground. She's showing me this. I don't know where the hell this is. I don't know if they were making a house somewhere, if they were going upstate, if they were doing something. I'm assuming it's East Coast, it's upstate. They're digging up something. She's like horrified. She's horrified at this. She's horrified at the money the checks are being spent on. I think it's her brother-in-law. She's horrified about something that's being spoken about with that and an ex-girlfriend of his. Okay, so there's a connection to I believe it's the husband's brother. Now, I think he had more than one brother, so I don't know which brother it is. I'm assuming I know which one it is from what I'm seeing in my head, but it's connected to an ex-girlfriend of that brother, and she's just like, fuck. Like, it's just like, fuck, what am I in? I'm in a hornet's nest. She didn't realize she was in a hornet's nest. This is where the depression was coming from. Yes, she did drink a bit. She liked to carry something in her purse and drink out of it, too. And I'm going to say something really weird here. Not only did she, like, secretly drink drinks, she may have drank stuff like cough syrup at times in this just because she would get overwhelming headaches and she would just need to tune out. So she may have done it for that reason, like, I've got a headache, I've got to do this. I don't know why you have to do it. It tastes like cough syrup. Ugh. Anyway, she was doing stuff like this. That is true, okay? So she was having issues. She was restrictive on what she was eating. She drinks a lot of either coffee or tea, puts her cup down like this. She's secretly smoking. Don't care what anyone says. She's secretly smoking, and I'm seeing it. And TikTok, she's in a hurry. TikTok, TikTok, I'm in a hurry. She's speaking to other people over here. There are people that know that she didn't commit suicide, by the way, and she's showing me men that absolutely know that she didn't commit suicide. Now, this has something to do with people that she reached out to talk to about whatever those checks were written for, but that's what she's telling me. She didn't commit suicide. And I know because I got letters from people that personally know her and people that were clients of mine and things like this, that she did commit suicide. I'm telling you, she didn't commit suicide from a psychic perspective. This is not what I'm getting, okay? So I want you guys to understand too, for as many suicides as these people have, people, human beings, are not committing suicide like that. There is something else being orchestrated in the psyches of these people because she's showing me and I'm back and forth like this. Like the energy is just like, I'm all over the place with it, okay? I'm all over. She kind of jumped into a certain lifestyle in a certain way to see if it would like fit her, okay? Which is apropos for somebody in fashion, but would it fit her? It didn't fit her. She tried to get out, but now her daughter's caught in it. This is what she's saying. She's wringing her hands for her daughter. Her daughter is not allowed to talk about her. Her daughter gets images and visions and impressions and in sleep state, leaves the body, is able to see. The mother holds her hand. The mother talks to her. The daughter cries. The daughter tries to tell people. No one wants to hear this. They want to call the daughter crazy. The daughter knows she can't speak about the mother. And that's what I'm going to say. I'm just going back and forth like this. I'm like, oh. So that tells me something at the end. I feel like Kate Spade, when she passed away, was given something in that saucer cup she drinks out of, which is like a teacup or a high teacup, a pretty teacup, a flowered teacup, a china teacup. She's drinking out of this, and I feel like there's something going on there that she's being drugged because I'm just like, I'm swaying back and forth. My head is going back and forth like I'm like this. And so I think she's trying to show me that she has quickened her tempo. She is like a madwoman speeding around. She's like, I have to get this done. She's showing me what was happening before she died. She knew it was a race before she would have suicided, which is another word for murder in my book, before she was suicided and before she could get the information out. This woman was trying to get the information out before this happened. And it was a real problem for her. People were listening, but they weren't stepping up quick enough. And then she died. That's what she's showing me. Then she sits there with her hands just like this, and she sits there and she has no idea what to do. And she's saying it was very scary because they were okay. She's showing me again the dig with the backhoe outside. I'm assuming it's upstate New York. I'm not really seeing what's around it, but I'm assuming it. She's showing me that, and she's being hoisted up. Hoisted. Something's being hoisted up and stuff is going on. There's so much stuff going on. She's randomly focused on cooking over here while turning her back, and all this is going on over here. They expected her, this is what I'm getting, they expected Kate to just turn around, sign over her business, sign over her assets, sign over her name, let them prostitute it out, her words, not mine, let them do this, collect billions of dollars, and then take her out because she wasn't playing the game. That's what she's telling me. I don't know what game we're playing and I'm still confused. And I need to take a breath. But for now, this is Sloan from SloanBella.com and I'll be back with another video.